In this video, I will go over the marketing strategy, target customer, and positioning strategy, which collectively contribute to your marketing plan. On the left is a list of marketing tools that you might consider in strategically considering which distribution channels you sell your products in and who your target customers are. There's advertising, which includes traditional as well as online advertising, sales promotions, events and experiences, public relations, direct marketing, and personal selling. All of these tools combined will be used to advertise to your target customers among the various places that you sell your products, which could be a farm stand, a CSA, farmers markets. Perhaps you wholesale your products as well. Who your target customer is will dictate which of these tools you can use to reach them most efficiently. One of the most important components of your marketing plan is your marketing strategy. That includes answering the following questions. What specific activities will you undertake? Identify the audience that each activity is targeted to. Specify how you will measure your success. Be flexible to allow for adjustments as needed. And finally, list who would be responsible for each activity. If you have more than one employee or person in your business, that will be responsible for marketing activities. Now let's focus on who your target customer will be. Remember, this is the group of people that you're going to concentrate your marketing efforts on. Where do they live? How old are they? What is their family status? Do they have children? And how old are those children? What is their income level? What are their interests? And finally, what is important to them? Now that you've given some thought to your target customer, the next item to consider is how to position your products in the mind of that customer. Positioning is the act of designing the business's offering and image to occupy a distinctive place in the mind of the target market. In the next slide, we will go over an exercise to develop a positioning statement for your products. This will then be integrated into your marketing strategy as part of your marketing plan. This exercise is a fill-in-the-blank exercise. So to come up with a positioning statement, on a sheet of paper or in a word processing document, you want to type up to and fill in your target audience and their need, our and fill in your product or your business, is, and then come up with a concept followed by a point of difference. So let's go over these two things. A concept is a fact about your product. The example provided will clarify this. A point of difference is what makes your product different from competitors. This becomes more subjective and really makes you focus on what makes your product the best and what you want your customers to say about your product. So let's look at the example here. This is for a vegetable CSA farm. So this is their positioning statement. To busy moms and dads who want to feed their kids healthy, locally grown fruits and vegetables. That includes the target audience and the need. We grow all of the produce we sell and offer 5 pickup locations. That's a fact or concept. With excellent customer service and clean, fresh produce. That's the point of difference, what makes this product different from their competitors. Now it's your turn. In a word processing document or a sheet of paper, go ahead and try to fill in your positioning statement. This will be shared in an assignment, and you can check this out in Moodle where to upload this. You can upload as a document or you can send it as an email. There is a due date on this one, and we will include that into your marketing plan in AgPlan. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions on the marketing strategy, target customer, or positioning strategy, let us know and we'll try to help you to develop these portions of your marketing plan.